In the year 2020, our team finds something very interesting in archaeoastronomy and mythology. It seemed that ancient myths had recorded the way to find in the stars the ecliptic line and its two poles. We named this system, this matrix, Astro-Mitra. Astro-Mitra just means starry matrix in Greek. For ancient stargazers, these elements were hard to find because of their awkward movement. Notice the oscillations of the ecliptic circle. You see the more stable blue line? This is the celestial equatorial circle. Each circle has its pole. The equatorial pole is the blue dot pointing toward Polaris, the North Star. The ecliptic pole is the orange dot turning around the North Pole. The ecliptic lines and its two poles are fixed with the stars. They are there for a long time. And probably it's one of the reasons why they represent eternal life in ancient mythology. The equatorial line and the equatorial pole are not permanent because of the precessions of the Earth. The equatorial line and the equatorial pole are easy to find. You find this in during a starry night in less than 12 hours. You find these directions. But the ecliptic lines and the ecliptic poles take years of survey, at least 1 year. Once you find the ecliptic lines in the sky, like the constellation of the zodiac, then you can put on a sphere, armillary sphere like this one, and from there you can find the ecliptic pole. And you do it by geometry, by calculations. But it's interesting because it doesn't seem too useful for practical life. When you take a modern armillary sphere like this, quite detailed, you find the ecliptic line with the zodiac, and you realize they didn't indicate the ecliptic pole because it seems like useless. This table resumes the two types of celestial movement. Notice each movement with its grid. For fishing, hunting, agriculture, just the moon and the solar calendars are enough. For navigation or navigation on the ocean or on the desert, you need the equatorial movements of the stars. That's it. But the ecliptic element seems to be related to the supernatural world, to religions, or to the afterlife. When our team discovered the Astro-Mitra, we realized that the ecliptic elements were so important for our ancestor, they decided to record it in their mythology. To better understand the Astro-Mitra, we have to look at the old sky map in a cylindrical projection. What is very disturbing is how they were exploiting some extraordinary coincidences. It's the amazing distributions of great magnitude stars. They are positioned by pairs along the meridians of the ecliptic grid. Moreover, the angular distances between these stars and the ecliptic are not trivial at all. They are spaced out using specific fractions of 90 degrees, integer denominators of 90 or its quarter. They help to locate precisely the ecliptic and its poles. You may ask how these primitive people were able to measure angles in the sky. But the most incredible fact is how they end up discovering such harmony in the stars. When I showed this to some astrophysicists and astronomer colleagues, they were just amazed, they were surprised. And I have to confess, I'm not a professional astronomer. I was trained as a geophysicist and geological engineer. I did some astronomy for my earthquake projects, so I'm a sort of amateur. I end up doing archaeoastronomy while in Turkey working with some projects with archaeologists. I have a passion for mythology, but I'm not a literary guy. So thanks to Aurélien Bloch, who helped me with all the aspects of compiling mythology. Thanks also to all these colleagues, astro-scientists and mythographers that helped me to correct my mistakes. And also to pinch me if I'm dreaming and if I'm doing cherry picking. Now, remember that the Astro-Mitra was just rediscovered after centuries of oblivion. And it seemed that it will relaunch the debate on teleology, the question of is our universe created with a purpose? I can explain this matrix solely with our ancestors' perceptions, which is limited to our Earth, but you won't be satisfied. Simply because you already learned the basics of modern astronomy in school. The Earth as a globe, the solar system, the axial tilt of the Earth and its seasons, the zodiac, the planets, the moon, the North Star. Just remember that the ecliptic grids is the one upon our solar system, and that the equatorial grid is built from the Earth's rotation around its axial tilt, which is 23.44 degrees. You might ask how the ecliptic line is oscillating or wobbling in our sky. Simple. Look at the mini ecliptic grid above your terrain. See the ecliptic line? This is your view of the solar system horizon from your terrain horizon. It's a low angle. The Earth rotates your terrain downward. Now the ecliptic is at the higher declinations in the sky of your terrain. All the transitional positions of your terrain will show a wobbling ecliptic in your sky. Just remember that any local grid is tilt according to its terrain's latitude. Here is an equatorial grid. Remember that the Astro-Mitra is the harmony between important stars and the ecliptic grid and its meridians. Keep in mind what you learn about these grids. Our ancestors did not know the mechanism behind the sky clock. They didn't have our privilege. They had a more spiritual or religious view of our universe, and we have a more materialistic view. If you're aware of what's going on in comparative mythology nowadays, you realize that the academics world accept well that the ancient mythology come from a single source in prehistoric time, Paleolithic time. This year we find something very interesting concerning the Milky Way by reading Astronomica of Eugenius. Is the story of Erigone and his father Icarius. And in this story they give clearly the constellations. There's different versions of the story or different bits of the story in different ancient writing. But they give constellations, and the main stars are arranged together to give degrees of 30, 60, and 90 degrees. And using this, suddenly you find the galactic pole. Quite interesting. As I say, the Astro-Mitra might relaunch the debate of teleology. Is our universe created on purpose? Is the Astro-Mitra a legacy given to all humankind? after studying a different approach in mythology, one thesis came to our attention. It's René Girard, or in English you pronounce René Girard, and it's about the scapegoat, the question of the sacrifice, the question of the mimetic desire. And strange enough, we start to relate this model to the Milky Way. By the way, we produced two short videos on the Milky Way to have a perspective of how the ancients perceived the Milky Way, how they perceived the Chaoskampf. You can watch these videos on our channel. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. And don't forget, we do appreciate collaborations with the academic world. It can be mythographers, it can be astronomers.